In the previous movie, we refined our courier's spawn animation via the graph editor. In this movie, we'll cover the export process to send our animated courier to DOTA 2. Open the file DOTA 2 courier part 5 start.mlt from the provided files or use your own scene. The export process for our courier is twofold. The first export will only contain the model itself and its skeleton. This file is used by DOTA 2 to register the geometry and skin weights bound to the skeleton. As we mentioned in the beginning of the series, the game requires two models for the courier's ground and flying variants. Here, since we're using the same courier mesh for both models, we'll use the same FBX file for both. The second export will consist of the courier's animations without its mesh. The game will play these animations based on the player's input or triggered events. To complement our courier's spawn animation, we've provided the remaining idle, run, and death animation clips required by DOTA 2, as well as a bonus alternative idle animation. You'll find all these clips in the files linked with this movie. To ensure that there are no animation offsets on our courier once it's imported into DOTA 2, we need its static model to be in its bind pose. Since the spawn animation starts at frame 1, let's store our courier's bind pose at frame 0. In the character controls, click the stance pose button to reset the control rig to its default T-stance pose. Select an effector and set a key in full body mode. Don't forget to also reset the facial controls before you key them. And make sure to set the faceplates and propeller controls to bind pose. Next, to streamline the export process, we'll create sets to quickly select the courier meshes and skeleton. Select the courier's skeleton hierarchy. Then go to Create, Sets, Set. Rename it to Courier Skeleton Set. Now select the skeleton hierarchy again, along with the courier's LOD1 group and propeller object. Create a new set and rename it to Courier In-Game Set. Repeat this process to create a third set for the skeleton and courier's LOD0 mesh. Rename it to Courier Portrait Set. Go to File, Game Exporter. The Game Exporter dialog provides access to commonly used export options, which can be saved locally as presets and then reused in other scenes. Note that you can still access the complete list of export options via the Advanced Settings button. Let's first export our in-game courier. In the Model tab, click the Add New Export Preset button. Rename it to DOTA 2 Courier Model. Choose Export Object Set from the following dropdown and select Courier In-Game Set from the adjacent one. Under Geometry, turn on Skinning to export the courier's skin clusters, which bind it to the underlying skeleton. Under Path, set your project folder as the export path, and enter Courier In-Game as the file name. You can use the standalone FBX review tool to inspect your output file before sending it to DOTA 2, however we'll skip that step here. For more information on FBX review, go to the Apps menu. Click Export. Repeat this process to export Courier Portrait Set, which corresponds to our courier's LOD1 mesh. This time, export the file as Courier Portrait. Click the Save Preset File to Disk button to store this configuration locally as a MEL script. Next, to export the courier's animation into its own file, go to the Animation Clips tab. Create a new preset. Set template to Anim Default and rename your preset to DOTA 2 Courier Anim. We want to export another set, but this time we'll choose Courier Skeleton Set, which contains the courier skeleton only. Under Animation Clips, click the Add New Clip button to add a new animation clip entry. Enter Spawn as its name, and set its start and end frame to 1 and 30 respectively. As you create more animations for your courier, you can add them to this list as well. Note that you can quickly frame the playback range around a clip instead of entering the range values manually. The Bake Animation option keys each joint on every frame, which ensures that our courier's animation is preserved once imported into Dota 2. Leave the drop-down below set to Save Multiple Clips to Single File. Note that if you have multiple clips, you can export them all as separate files. Set Path to your project folder, and enter Courier Ground Spawn as the file name. Note that when you use the Save Multiple Clip Files drop-down option, MayaLT uses the file name value as a prefix in the output clip's name. Click Export. Make sure to save your export animation preset as we've done earlier with the model preset. Launch Dota 2 and navigate to the Steam Workshop page. Under Publish New Submission, click Courier. Enter a unique name for your courier. Next, click Ground. The first page of this section refers to the ground courier's geometry. Set the in-game geometry and optional portrait geometry to the corresponding FBX files you just exported. You can also use the provided files linked with this movie. Set the texture files to couriercolor.tga, also found in the provided files. Go to the next page. In the first animation section, load the courier's spawn, idle, run, and death animations into the corresponding fields. The other two animation sections are for optional clips. Here, we'll import the Courier Ground Idle Rare and Courier Ground Idle Rare Portrait FBX files. Go to the Attachments section. Enter Courier Head, Courier Left Up Eye, and Courier Right Up Eye in the following fields. Go back to the Courier Submission page. The Ground section should be marked as ready. Repeat the same process for the Flying Courier. Recall that we've exported the same courier model for both the ground and flying variants, so we'll be reusing the Courier In-Game and Courier Portrait FBX files. In the Attachments section, use the same joints as before. We'll leave out the marketing section of the submission process at this point and go ahead with the import. Once the import process is complete, we can preview our courier in both its ground and flying modes. And under different lighting conditions. We can also toggle between its animation clips. Go to the portrait editor to adjust the camera framing and lighting setup. Use the provided preset files to quickly set these. You can launch a local game to take your shiny new courier out for a spin. Click Submit to finalize your courier. Another way to export your custom Courier to Dota 2 is via the Steam Workshop tools available in Maya LT for Steam. In the Dota 2 Exporter dialog, the Courier tab lists all the fields found in the Steam Workshop's Courier submission page. Once you've loaded the corresponding model geometry, animation files, and attachment joints, click Export to create a quick save text file in your local Dota 2 folder, which contains the paths related to your meshes, animation files, and textures. In the Steam Workshop tab, load this quick save file to automatically fill in the submission fields with the exported data and proceed from there. Note that if you run into problems while importing your model into Dota 2, you can diagnose the resulting MDL file using HLMV or Half-Life Model Viewer. HLMV is an application used to preview 3D models created for the source engine, specifically MDL files. HLMV can be launched from your local Dota 2 folder. You can find more information on how to use HLMV on the Steam community website. In this series, we breathe life into a new Dota 2 courier using several rigging and animation techniques. Using what you've learned here, you can create your own custom courier to send those bottles and wards to your teammates.